Have you ever wondered how the Feast of Christ the King came into being? Probably not. And you might even say, is it that relevant? Yes, it is. So, getting a little bit of background. Pius XI in 1925 is the one who promulgated this being a major feast day, Christ the King, at the end of the church year. He wanted to emphasize, for Christians certainly, the importance of the Lord Jesus being the one we most follow and submit our lives to. And the reason he was doing that in 1925 is because kind of coming to the fore in the various European countries that included those who had primarily Christian majorities, what was emerging was a form of nationalism, Nazism, and communism in a way that certainly relegated Christian principles to the side. And two main Catholic Christian principles that he focused on then, and we need to hear them now. First of all, was upholding the dignity, the equality, and the right to life of every human being. And secondly, to recognize that with all our differences and diversity on this planet Earth, we are to recognize, too, that we are part of one human family. Yes, we have our own nation states, we have our own families. At the same time, though, to know at the core how we live and how we love, we are one human family on this planet Earth. God is Father of us all. And so those two principles, the dignity of each person and the fact that on this planet we're all in this together, he saw that more and more Christian countries moving away from those ideals and tried to emphasize what we need to hear even today. Is Jesus Christ our dominant influence in who we are, how we think, what we look at life, the decisions we make? You know, in that gospel, we have that notion of Pilate talking about truth. Even later, he says to Jesus, what is truth? And truth, to measure that, to understand that in some way too. And Pius XI and since then other popes too have spoken about this truth, saying we need to see and understand not just doctrinal truths we have, which are important, but are we living the truth in the way Jesus calls us to live? So, for example, we know this, and popes have made this point, even back at the time of the Reformation. Primary emphasis on doctrinal truth, and it was the most important core thing. Well, Catholics and Christians of other denominations were at war with each other over that. Catholics would kill Protestants because they didn't have the same belief in the Eucharist and the Pope. Protestants would kill Catholics because they didn't think Catholics had the right understanding of Scripture. You know, doctrinal truths in which they were killing each other in the name of Jesus Christ. Now we look back at Jesus, talk about truth, the lived truth. Jesus knew the doctrinal truths of his day. And again, are they important? Yes, but they're not what matters most. So, for example, the Pharisees were upset with Jesus because he healed on the Sabbath. Doctrinal truth. You don't do any labor on the Sabbath. He did. Why did he do it? Because of the belief that love is even a greater truth. And also another one, Jesus would dine with sinners. No way, if you were Jewish and kept your faith, were you ever to dine with sinners. Doctrinal truth. But he had a lived truth that he lived by and calls us to notice and live by first. And basically, we heard a couple weekends ago what that lived truth was and is that he exemplified. He talked the talk and he walked the walk. And it was basically this, when the lawyer asked, well, what commandments are most important? What did they come down to? And he said, to love the Lord your God with all your heart, your mind, your soul, your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. That's it. Those are the fundamentals. That's what we're called to live. Again, All those other truths have their place and to follow. But if it gets in the way of the call to love God with our whole being and neighbors ourselves, then we have to kind of reflect and be critical. Today, we need to look at that too, don't we? Because in our own age, we can get caught up in that. People can fight with one another over certain aspects of how to live and what to be. And there are differences. But again, even in our nation where we recognize differences, and it's the heart of democracy working together. But do we do that in a way where we speak the truth as best we understand it in love? And never speak or espouse any philosophy that calls for hate or calls for rejection of people just because of who they are, their color or their religion or their background. For all of us today, especially in looking at our personal lives, is Jesus Christ the one we look to when we make all those decisions on whatever level? And say, Lord, help us understand. And Lord, even help us understand the practical application, because there can be legitimate differences of this. Help us to understand the practical application of what it means to love you with our whole being and love our neighbor, which is every human being on this planet, as ourselves. So, we gather here, 1925, it needed to be emphasized. It still does, and it will in every generation. So take a quiet moment, and maybe even as we wrap this up, truly really turn to the Lord, because we can look at even our everyday situations with our families, our co-workers, and so forth. Lord, help me to see how I can best live your will, and if I fall short, to ask forgiveness and experience your grace to be better. Take that quiet moment. God bless you.